All right. Hello, Smith Station. I'm Don Pimentel here with another episode of PNN. Today's show goes out to the basketball team. You guys are doing great. We need everyone to come out and support them at 5 o'clock here tonight. Here's Ben and Cam with your announcements.
Good afternoon, Smith Station. Any student who would like to audition for a role in the upcoming musical needs to plan to audition Monday, the January 23rd, starting at 4 p.m. in Mr. Fuller's room, room 305. For more information, see Mr. Fuller.
Prom and the winter formal are coming up, and Ms. Hilliard and the Colored Guard are sponsoring the Smith Station Dress Closet. All dresses are $20. Stop by and take a gander at those dresses.
A gander?
Yeah, a gander.
Students that are interested in the Art Institute College and are interested in obtaining a degree in design, art, photography, or culinary arts, please see the guidance offices for information as well as great scholarship opportunities offered by the college.
Are they cops now?
Guidance?
Officers.
I guess. Counselors or cops?
January 31st is the deadline to apply for scholarships to CSU. This includes honors and servant leadership.
A $50 deposit out of the $100 senior dues is due January the 18th to your homeroom teacher. The balance isn't due until April 11th, and if you don't pay them, can't go to prom, so.
Which is, you know, bad.
Sucks for you. Oops. Bad for you. I didn't say anything else. That's it. Bad.
Auburn University in Montgomery is hosting an open house preview day on January 21st, 2012 from 8:30 to 1:30. You may register online at www.aum.edu/warhawkwelcome.com.
You didn't say War Eagle today.
No, I didn't say it this time.
Also, the 2011-2012 Playing with a Purpose Scholarship Program is now accepting applications. The deadline to apply is March 1st, 2012. Hold on. Well, this can't be 2013. I don't know.
Yeah, we have to say 2012.
Yeah.
We have to say the day. Anyway. Okay. Southern Union offers scholarships in dance, music, theater, and technical support, which is lighting and all that good stuff.
And camera people like the guy behind us, well, in front of us.
Yeah. The audition and interviews are scheduled for March 12th and 13th, 2012. The deadline of submission of all documents to is March 1st. Remember that you must have completed 2012-2013 free application for federal student aid and request that Southern Union receive your FAFSA information.
Having some trouble? Big boy. The big boy is trying to not take a break.
No,
I get you. Senior interested in pursuing a degree in theater and invited to attend auditions for department scholarships and admissions to the musical theater track, as well as a portfolio review for design/tech students on Saturday, January 21st. The registration deadline is January 17th, and the register call 205-348-5283 or email theater.dance@ua.edu.
Best Buy is awarding 1,200 scholarships of $1,000 each to students in grades 9 through 12. You may apply from December 26, 2011.
I'm in 12th grade.
You are in 12th grade?
Yeah.
Yeah, we know.
Well, why did it say 2011?
Because that's when it started.
It was a long time ago, so you don't need that.
December 26, 2011 to February 15, 2012 at www.bestbuy-communityrelations.com or www.at15.com. You have to say hyphen so they know.
All right. There will be an information session for the Savannah College of Art and Design in Montgomery, Alabama on Thursday, January 12th at 7 o'clock Central Standard Time at the Renaissance Montgomery Hotel and Convention Center at 201 Tallapoosa Street. That's an awkward
Yeah, Tallapoosa.
All right, just read.
Yeah. Jacksonville State University will host spring preview days for high school and students and their families on Saturday, February 4th and April 14th, 2012. I said families a bunch. Activities begin at 9 a.m. Central Standard Time.
To be exact, you said it three times.
I did.
For all other announcements of school news, head over to PantherNews.com. Calm. Cameron Cotton.
Ben Wallace. And I'm going to go ahead and make clear, I did not say War Eagle yesterday.
Here's Amy with your weather.
Good afternoon, Smith Station. I'm Amy Henderson, and I am back with your weather. Today is mostly sunny with a high of 48 and only a low of 27. And through the weekend, it's going to continue to be sunny, and it's going to warm up just a tad with a high in the lower 60s and lows in the lower 30s. So stay warm and have a great end of the week.
Here's sports with Mason and Lemansky.
Welcome back, Smith Station. This is the first sports show of 2012. We hope you enjoyed your Christmas break.
In this episode, we're going to break down the BCS title game, which featured the Alabama Crimson Tide and the LSU Tigers.
The Alabama Crimson Tide defeated LSU Tigers 21-0 with an offensive game. The Alabama defense, though, was stellar, holding the LSU Tigers to 92 total offensive yards. Some key players of defense was Dante Hightower and Nick Gentry of the defensive line. Nick Gentry was powerful legs, just breaking through the tackles and getting lots of sacks. The defense also held them to 5 first downs and a 2-for-12 on third down conversions. LeMaxie, what about the LSU offense?
Well, the LSU offense, you know, they didn't get anything going. They tried to get a running game going, but against Alabama's defense, it's just too tough. And then they pressured Jordan Jefferson, and they forced him to do things that he really doesn't do. And, you know, Les Miles was faced with a tough decision to either change the quarterback or leave him on. He left Jordan Jefferson on, and a lot of people were very confused by that decision. And LSU's defense really didn't help the cause because they gave up a lot of points, as you said, 21. And, you know, they really wasn't playing LSU football. So, Mason, tell us about Alabama's offense.
Yeah, Alabama offense was stellar, with A.J. McCarron having the game of his career with 243 yards. Kevin Norwood had to step up in the receiving game because Marquise Mays had injured on a punt return early in the first quarter. Kevin Norwood had 4 receptions for 78 yards. Another offensive player was Trip Richardson. He had 20 carries, but only 90 yards. He did have a touchdown in the fourth quarter. It was 34 yards, making the game 21-0.
And then with the win, it makes the state of Alabama 3 straight times that they won a national championship. 2 years ago being Alabama, last year being Auburn, this year Alabama again.
Yeah, that's also Nick Saban's second with Alabama. What about the player of the game for you? Who would that be?
The player of the game for me would be A.J. McCarron. You know, a lot of people didn't expect him to play as well as he did, and he had his best career game on the biggest stage against arguably one of the best defenses in the nation. So I thought that was very nice for him. Who do you think was player of the game?
A.J. McCarron did pretty good with 243 yards, but I'm going to say Jeremy Shelley. He won that game for Alabama with 5 field goals. He missed 2, but I give it to him.
Lamansky Flakes.
Mason Donaldson.
PNN.
Remember, a line is a dot that just went for a walk. Message of inspiration from your friends at PNN. Have a great day, Smith Station.